Hello students, welcome back. In the previous section, we saw how we can acquire data or how we can acquire evidence from either a Windows workstation or a Linux workstation using a multitude of tools. We saw how to capture those evidences using a tool FTK Imager. We also saw that there is a difference between static and live evidences. We saw that static evidences can be captured easily with the help of the freely available tools. But on the other hand, the live evidences are very crucial because once you switch off your computer system, the live evidences vanish. So it is very important to keep your computer system on and then acquire the evidences, whatever evidences you can capture from the RAM using RAM dumps. In this section, we are going to learn about something that we call as wireless network forensics. We are going to learn about what exactly is a wireless network, how the communication on the internet happens, and how we can acquire evidences from a live crime scene. So just take an example that there is a crime going on and somehow you come to know that some data is missing from your computer or some malicious activity is happening on your computer or even on your network. So being a digital forensic investigator, it's your role, it's your job to investigate the entire crime scene. So what are we going to do in this section? We are actually going to learn what is a wireless network, how to capture packets or acquire packets, in short, how to sniff the packets from the network. Packet sniffing is basically acquiring or capturing packets which are flowing across a network. Now, we all know that in the internet, a packet is nothing but the smallest term or smallest unit of any communication. On the internet, the entire data cannot go in one shot from the source to the destination. It is basically broken down into smaller fragments called packets. And it goes through n number of network components such as routers, switches, gateways, hubs, etc. So there is quite a possibility of an attack which can take place on these intermediate nodes that is present between the source and the destination. So packet sniffing is basically a process in which we actually sniff what are those packets flowing across a particular network. And are those packets malicious? Are those packets actually genuine? Are those packets carrying any malicious payload? Are those packets sent by an attacker inside the network to carry out any malicious activity? These all questions will be answered in the packet sniffing or packet capturing section. The next section will focus on the packet analysis. That is, all those packets which we have captured in the previous step will be analyzed in this step. It is again a very important phase because once you capture the packets, it's your role to analyze those packets, to check the headers, to check the payloads, whether they are safe or not. That activity is done using packet analysis. And towards the end, we are going to learn how to actively acquire access to a Wi-Fi network. For example, there is a system which might have been attacked. It's your role to move inside that network to check whether everything is fine or not. So just take an example that there is a computer system or a computer network which has been compromised. So how will you gain access to the network, either actively or passively, and monitor the network for any suspicious activity? We are going to learn about that in this last section. So without wasting much time, let's jump to the theory behind what exactly is packet sniffing, and then we will start our practical lab sessions on packet sniffing, packet analysis, and Wi-Fi network access. So stay tuned.
So what exactly is packet sniffing? And how has it got so much importance in the recent days? Let's start with the actual definition of packet sniffing. We can define the act of capturing packets of the data flowing across a computer network as packet sniffing. The software or the device which is used to carry out this process is called as a packet sniffer. You can try to correlate the concept of packet sniffing with something called as wiretapping. Wiretapping is a process of overhearing or eavesdropping the communication line by placing a small hardware unit called as a tapper or a wiretap in between the communication channel. We can compare this scenario with packet sniffing. As the technology has advanced with many folds, packet sniffing is basically a complicated or a sophisticated version of wiretapping, where you make use of various hardwares and softwares to carry out the similar task but in a more sophisticated fashion. The original purpose of packet sniffing was basically to carry out all the network maintenance activities and administrative purposes such as penetration testing and monitoring the traffic on a network. But along with the popularity of the packet sniffers, also came the risk of potential attacks by hackers or black hat hackers. For that purpose, the hackers and crackers used to gather information illegally about networks they intend to break into. Using the packet sniffer, it is very much possible to capture the data such as passwords, IP addresses, protocols which are being used on the network and the other information that will help the attacker infiltrate the network. As we know, all the network data travels across the internet and then it moves into or out of the PCs in the form of individual variable sized packets using the TCP/IP protocol suite. Since a communication cannot happen in one go, the message is broken down into multiple fragments and then sent in sequence. At the receiving end, the packets are being received and arranged according to the sequence numbers. This is exactly where the attacker comes into picture. He or she may wiretap the communication and somehow get hold of the packets using any packet sniffer tool such as Wireshark and combine the packets in sequence to obtain the complete message. This generally happens when the attacker has access to the internal network, and it is rarely possible if the attacker is outside the network. So we can say that packet sniffer may be, or packet sniffing to be precise, may be an insider attack. So how to protect our system against such attacks? Basically, by ensuring that we make use of secure protocols, for example, HTTPS instead of HTTP, and encrypting the data packets before sending or receiving any data packet on the internet will make us protected against the attackers or hackers using packet sniffing tools. Apart from this, we can also make use of virtual private networks or VPNs to create a secure tunnel using which we can communicate safely without being on the radar of the packet sniffers or attackers. As a result, we may safeguard our systems and the servers from the attacks of the hackers.
Hello viewers, so let's first of all understand what exactly packet sniffing is. So first of all, packet sniffing is a process in which specialized devices called as packet sniffers are placed strategically inside the network, which will keep on intercepting the packets of data flowing across that network. So that after a considerable amount of time, the packet sniffers will have a huge amount of data, which can be further analyzed to extract useful information out of those packets. Let us understand how the communication on the internet happens. First of all, packet sniffing is basically the process of gathering, collecting, and logging some or all of the packets that pass through a network, regardless of how the packet is addressed. In short, suppose there are 5 computers inside a network. Even if the packet is traveling from computer A to computer B or computer A to computer C, that is not our concern. The packet sniffers can be set in a promiscuous mode in which they will understand each and every packets and they will try to capture all the packets destined from all the sources to all the destinations. In short, all the messages that are broadcasted or all the messages that are flowing through that network can be captured with the help of packet sniffing. As we all know, the internet is the most insecure medium of communication. Whenever a particular web page is opened or emails are sent, they are not sent as a single document. They are broken down into multiple data units, which we called as data packets. These packets are then addressed to an IP address at the receiving end. These packets are then combined and the ultimate output is delivered to the destination. This is how the packets are sent and received on the internet. But just consider a scenario. We have just now seen that these packets are not sent as a whole. They are being divided into multiple fragments called packets and then sent to the destination. So what if an attacker comes in between the communication process and hacks any of the networking devices present in between? Just take the scenario that a particular web page is broken down into 5 packets and these 5 packets go through n number of network components such as routers, hubs, switches, etc. So what is the bottleneck in this process? The switches, the routers, and all the network components itself are the bottleneck in this process. If a traffic analysis or a packet capturing happens on these networking devices, then all the traffic can be sniffed and valuable data can be captured out of those packets. Just take an example. Over here, as you can see, this particular web page is being requested by this destination. Now what happens, this particular web page, as we had discussed just now, cannot be sent in a single datagram. It needs to be broken down into multiple packets. And these packets go through multiple switches, multiple routers, etc. until they reach the destination. This is the ideal scenario. But just take an example where this is an attacker over here. The attacker simply connects to this network and captures all the packets traveling through that particular switch. Now, how to connect to a network? That is what we are going to learn in this particular session. The first video is going to focus on how to capture all the packets using TCP dump. The second video is all about analyzing those packets which we have captured using TCP dump. And the third video will be how to access a particular Wi-Fi network by actively cracking into it, by actively cracking Wi-Fi networks using multiple tools available on the internet. So this is how the communication works. And this is how the attacks also take place. Now, who can sniff packets? Anyone who has access to a router can perform packet collection and analysis, right? Since the internet users generally have no idea how their traffic is being routed, it is not really possible to know who may be observing that traffic. As we all know, there are multiple hops involved in between through which the packet reaches us, and hence it is very difficult to identify where and when the actual attack has taken place, because this sort of an attack is a passive attack where the attacker doesn't reveal his or her identity and silently captures all the packets. So it is very difficult to get hold of who has actually sniffed our packets. Government agencies use packet sniffing just to ensure the security of data over the network. They can track an organization's unencrypted data as well. These are the common tools which are generally used by any digital forensic investigator or even by the attackers. Just a point to mention over here, the tools remain the same, only the objectives, only the intentions differ. If I am an attacker, I may use Wireshark or TCP dump or any other tool to capture the packets and then launch an attack. If I am a digital forensic investigator or a security analyst, I would be using Wireshark and TCP dump to analyze the network flaws, and I would try to rectify those flaws. So ultimately the tools remain the same, the toolkits remain the same. Only difference is in the intention, the ethics and the objectives. Fine. So we are going to learn about TCP dump, EtherCAP and many other tools using which we are going to see how a network forensics is conducted. So let's understand what is TCP dump before actually starting off with the practical session. TCP dump is a very simple tool, command line tool, which prints out a description of contents of packets on a network interface that matches certain Boolean expressions. So depending upon what options I provide, depending upon what options I provide after TCP dump command, it will fetch out the result and display it to me. Similarly, the description is preceded by a timestamp, printed by default as hours, seconds, minutes, etc. So it will also give me a particular timeline when the particular command was fired, when a particular packet is generated, when a particular packet is going from one location to the other location. So it also gives me a timeline that is very handy from the chain of custody point of view. We can also save the output of a TCP dump process into a file using the -w flag. So this is how we can make use of TCP dump for our capturing and analysis process. So without wasting much time, let's dive in for the practical session on TCP dump. So let's start our practical session on TCP dump. The very first thing that you need to make sure is, we are considering a scenario where the main machine, or you can say the main OS, is Windows 10, on which I am running this VirtualBox, Oracle VirtualBox, inside which Kali Linux is installed, right? So I'm having two operating systems running. The first one is my Windows OS and the second one is my Linux OS, right? So what you need to do is, as you can see, we are having our taskbar over here where I have connected to my Wi-Fi. Now we are going to share this internet on our Kali Linux machine. So to do so, the very next step is you need to go to the devices, go to network settings, and just make sure that you are connected to a bridged adapter. If you are connected to a bridged adapter, it will automatically share your host network, and it can be used to access the internet and the guest network also. So let me quickly switch on the terminal and let me check the network configurations with ifconfig. And as you can see, if the network settings and the bridge adapter is working fine, you should be able to see this sort of an IP address. Let me show you if by default you have selected this network, that is, instead of a bridged adapter, you have selected NAT, then what will happen? If I run this ifconfig again over here, you should be able to see IP address something like this, 10.0.2.15. In such a case, you won't be able to carry out TCP dump. You should be sharing an actual internet. Over here, this is nothing but a dummy or a proxy sort of a network. You won't be able to access a network using this IP address. Fine. So that's why you should switch to bridged network instead of a NAT network. So just make sure that you have selected this bridge adapter. And once you click on bridge adapter, you will be able to see the list of adapters your host machine supports. So simply select bridge adapter and click on OK. And now let's again check the ifconfig. It should take a little time. So let's just assume that this is the IP address or this is the computer of the attacker. So you can say that the Kali machine is the attacker's machine and your host machine, that is the Windows machine, that is your victim's machine. So let's check the IP address of our victim's machine also. Well, in real cases, it won't be that easy. Simply go to command prompt and check the IP address. You would have to perform a lot of operations. For example, you will have to patiently monitor the network. You should be able to check the packets flowing across the network, and then you will be able to deduce what is the IP address of your target system. In this case, we know that our target machine and the attacker's machine both are running on the same system. So it is very easy to simply check the IP address of the Windows machine by simply going onto the console. There is a command prompt and typing ipconfig. And this particular IP you see over here, this is the IP address of your victim's machine, that is 192.168.0.106. So that's all the preliminaries we are going to require in this video. So let's start with the practicals, that is TCP dump, using our first command over here, that is TCP dump space minus H. Minus H, as we all know, will give me a list of all the options that we can use along with TCP dump. So this is our very first command, TCP dump minus H. So let me copy all these commands, and I will be in a position to give you a list of all the commands that have been fired over here. So let me open Notepad, and the first command over here is this, and paste over here, that is help. Fine. So this is our very first command, TCP minus H. Now let's check how actually TCP works. It's very simple. TCP dump minus TCP dump space minus I. What is minus I? I is nothing but the interface. Now we saw in ifconfig that we have two interfaces. Let me again quickly show it to you just to avoid any confusions. We have two interfaces. This is the interface on which our internet is working, and this is the loopback interface just for testing purpose. So we are going to consider this only, that is interface Ethernet 0. Now let me give you a scenario. As both our machines are working on the same computer, we are going to use the Ethernet 0 interface. Towards the later sections, specifically during Wi-Fi attack, we are going to see that instead of Ethernet 0, we will actually require a wireless LAN interface. Because in ideal scenarios, we are not present inside the network physically. We are actually connecting to the wireless router, and then we will try to launch an attack on that victim. So in such a case, we would be requiring a wireless LAN interface. And for that, you would be needing a Wi-Fi device or a Wi-Fi adapter. I will show exactly what I'm talking about in our next few videos, where we will actually launch a Wi-Fi attack on a router. Fine. So let's stick to Ethernet 0 interface in this video. In the future, we are going to learn about wireless LAN 0 interface also. Fine. So let's have a look. What is the next command? Next command is TCP dump space minus I for the interface, select Ethernet 0, and then space minus V. Minus V stands for verbose. Verbose is nothing but everything that you type on the screen, the output for that corresponding command will be shown to you line by line. Fine. So that's it. This is the command. Let's see what is the output of this particular command. If you are not a super user, it may give you some error like this. You don't have permission to capture on that device. So to ignore this, you simply need to type sudo, and then it will ask you for the password of this machine. Simply enter that, and this is what you will get. So just have a look. I have simply entered tcp dump minus I ethernet 0 minus V. So basically what it is doing is it has already started capturing the packets which are flowing through that network interface ETH 0. So whatever computers are connected, whichever computers are connected to that ethernet 0 interface, all the packets will be captured. So as a result, you can see that it is actually quite difficult to read it like this, but don't worry, whenever we will write it into a file, it will be very easy to read and analyze. That is our topic for the next video, that is analyzing the packet captures. In this video, we are going to stick with how to capture the traffic. So this is how the traffic is captured. As you can see, the length of this particular packet is this much byte. It has been captured around this time. It is a packet which is following the ARP protocol. If you know ARP, address resolution protocol, so it is basically asking all the computers connected on the network, what is your IP, what is your corresponding MAC address to this particular IP address. And once the connection is established, all the communication can take place. So as you can see, this is an ARP request, and on response to that, this is the ARP reply that it has received. Now 0.1 is nothing but the IP address of the main gateway. So the gateway reverts back that for this particular IP address, there is a particular MAC address. So as you can see, this is the particular MAC address for that ARP packet. So it's very simple, as you can visualize each and everything. So what exactly happens, let me again repeat it. Whenever the communication is up, an ARP packet is sent out requesting to give me the reply for this particular IP address. So the gateway, which is having IP address of 0.1, it will reply back that for the IP address which you were requesting, this is the corresponding MAC address. So similarly, different protocols also run. We are not only concerned with ARP. Different protocols are run inside a network. It could be TCP, it could be IP, it could be any other protocol, ICMP protocol for that matter. So all those packets will be captured, and it is very easy to capture all those packets using TCP dump. This process will keep on continuing, so simply press Ctrl C and move out of it. So as you can see, 55 packets were captured and one packet was dropped. In short, 56 packets were received by the filter. It's that cool, right? So let me go and paste it over here. The second command, TCP dump minus E. Just simply write sudo in front of it, and that's it. This is our second command. So let's now move on towards our third command. Our third command is basically, let me clear the screen for you. Our third command is basically specific to a particular host. For example, what is the IP address of this machine? The IP address of this particular machine is nothing but 192.168.0.107, if I'm not wrong. Let me check it once again. ifconfig. Yes, I was correct. 192.168.0.107. And the target's machine, that is the victim's machine, is 0.106. So what we can do is, we can now stick to capturing the packets which have the source address corresponding to the victim's address, which is 0.106. So for that, what we can do is, we can simply make a change to the command, that is sudo tcp dump minus I Ethernet 0 interface minus V, followed by adding something like this: host space 192.168.0.106. Now 0.106 corresponds to the IP address of the source, or we can say the victim's IP address. So we are limiting the capture to only this particular host. So what we are doing from this command onwards is simply called as filtering our packet capture. Whatever command you can see after minus V is nothing but a filter which is used to capture packets only from the host, which is having a source IP address of 192.168.0.106. So once I press enter, only the packets which are originating from 0.106 will be displayed on your screen. Let's have a look. It will start slowly, and whenever there is any activity on your victim's machine using the internet, that will be highlighted over here. Let me open a browser and go to a website, and let's check if there is any activity happening over here or not. As you can see, once I click on google.com, there is something happening over here. Fine. Let me terminate this command and let's see what are the packets captured. So far 36 packets have been captured. I simply opened up the browser and typed google.com, and for that 36 packets were captured. As you can see, Google Cast. So it will also tell you which is the IP address or which is the website I was trying to visit using my browser. So as you can see, let me scroll up. After this particular command, it was listening patiently what I am doing on my machine. So as you can see, 192.168.0.106, it had started with this particular IP address of length 173. So these are all the actions or activities happening behind. That is, I simply went into the browser, I typed google.com, and along with that command, these are all the operations that were taking place in the background. So as you can see, my first command went to the gateway, and the gateway then fetched the IP address of google.com using DNS, and it displayed that so and so maybe the IP address of that Google server. So that was fetched and displayed on my browser. So as you can see, this google.com page is displayed properly without any error. It simply means that a particular website exists on whatever location or whatever IP address this is fetching. So as you can see, a simple looking HTTP request may have so many processes running at the background. Fine. So all those packets can be captured using this particular tool, TCP dump. So this is my third command. Let me copy this command once again for you and paste it over here. Now we are going to see the reverse of this command. That is, instead of host, let me see if I want to stick to the destination PC only. For example, my PC, that is my computer. If I want to capture the packets which are incoming to my computer system, then I can change it from host to destination DST, and all the packets which are destined for my computer, only those packets will be fetched and displayed. Fine, let me show you how it is done. So let me go back to my victim's machine, and if I fire a simple command, that is ping. I guess you are having the knowledge of ping. What is ping? Ping is basically running on ICMP echo requests. So if I ping a particular network, for example, 192.168.0.107, that is my destination network, it should give me a reply back because both these networks are active. By chance, if my destination is unavailable, it will not receive the responses within some particular amount of time. So now once I press enter, you will see that there will be a lot of activities happening on the attacker's machine. Why? Let me clear this fact. As you can see, this command is basically modified to capture only the packets which are destined for the attacker's machine, that is the IP address 107. So all the packets which are arriving at this particular computer system, only those will be captured by the traffic sniffer if I use this command. Clear? So now let me press enter, and you can see it clearly that once I press enter, or once I press the command, once I activate that command, all the packets which are destined for this computer system at IP address ending with 107, those packets are being captured and displayed on your screen. So it is very crucial, it is very important, not only from the attacker's point of view, but also from a system defense point of view, where you will be able to see what are the packets which are destined for your computer system, and you will get to know what is the protocol running behind that packet. So as you can see, this is nothing but a simple ICMP ECO request packet. So not only the packet size, the IP address, but also the protocol which is running behind that particular packet will also be shown. Am I clear? So this is our fourth command. Let me copy it. Let me copy the command over here. Instead of source host, we are having destination in this particular command. That is the only change. Fine. So let's move on with the fifth command. Now the fifth command is basically a combination of third and fourth command. What happens over here is, let me show you. If I want to capture a particular device, if I want to capture a particular traffic where the destination and source are fixed, then I can use this command. Just have a look. You simply need to add and src, that is the source, and the IP address of that source. Isn't it cool? It is very simple. You simply need to make some modifications to the command, and by doing so, what we will do is we will start capturing the packets only which are having the source address ending with .106 and the destination address ending with .107. Once I click enter, again the same thing will happen. Let me again go back to the console and show it to you what happens. Again, the packets will be captured and stored. Simple. So whichever machine is having 192.168.0.106 as the source IP address, if I send any packet from that machine to this computer system with 107 as the IP address, all those packets will be captured by our packet sniffer, or you can say packet capturer, that is TCP dump. Isn't it cool? So this was my fourth command, right? Let me again copy it and paste it over here. Now let's move on towards our sixth command. Our sixth command is again very important. Let's have a look what it is. Our sixth command is like, if you want to restrict your search or restrict your packet capturing to only certain protocols, how to do it? As you know, there are approximately 1000 well-known ports and multiple protocols running on those ports. So if I want to restrict my packet capturing to only certain protocols, how to do so? Well, again, it's very simple. You simply need to do certain changes. Till here, the command is exactly same. After this, what we need to do is, you simply need to type the name of the protocol. For example, TCP. So all the packets which are having protocol as TCP, only those packets will be captured using this filter. So let me press enter. So if a TCP packet or a TCP request is created or generated, then such a packet will be captured. Otherwise, it won't be captured. Fine. As we are not having any TCP request running over here, the packets are not getting captured. Let me open one website and see if that is getting captured or not. Let me open a website. It is not getting captured. But if I change this protocol to something else, for example ARP, and then check. If I again run this command, it has started working out. It has started capturing the packets. Why so? Because as you can see over here, the packet ICMP basically makes use of ARP to check whose MAC address is matching this particular IP address. So it is nothing but ARP protocol. So all those packets which are running on ARP, those packets will be captured. And that is very cool, isn't it? So this is what our sixth command is all about. If you want to restrict your packet capturing to certain protocols, you can do so very easily with the help of this particular command. I hope you are enjoying this video so far. So let's move on to our next command. That is, we are going to restrict our searching or packet capturing not only to protocols, but this time to certain port numbers also. So as you can see, the command is like this: sudo tcp dump minus I ethernet 0 minus V port 80. So instead of a protocol, that is TCP, we are making use of a port, that is port 80, and press enter. So it's very simple, whichever packet or whichever IP datagram is using TCP port number 80, all those packets can be easily captured using this particular command. So let me copy this command and paste it over here. That is port 80. Similarly, you can close this and change it to 443. That is HTTPS, SSL. So whichever protocol is running, so whichever packet is running this particular port number, you will be able to capture those packets using this particular command. Isn't it cool? So we have so far seen 7 commands. Let me move on to my next command, and my next command is, it is not a compulsory thing, but to have a good practice similar to programming, we usually comment out some piece of code just for easy understanding. Similarly, it is considered to be a good practice to add all those filters inside single quotes. So how it is done? You simply need to type in a single quote, and then whatever command you wish, you can put it over there. For example, this is my command. I would simply put a single quote over here and at the end. So it is considered to be a good practice of writing a command with the use of TCP dump. So it will help you distinguish between what is a command and what is a filter. Fine, so if I click on it, it will work similar to previously what we had seen. Let me again type something. For example, trace route or ping. That should work. So it will work in the same fashion. Only thing is, you are writing it in a way that it is more readable as compared to what it was previously. Fine. So let me again copy this command and paste it over here. Now we have almost come to the end of this tutorial. The only command left is how to write the output of a particular capturing process into a file. It's very important because, as you can see, it is very difficult to read and analyze what exactly is happening on this console, right? So it becomes very much important to write all the captures into a particular file with extension .pcap. Let me now clear the screen because a lot of thing has happened over here on the console, just to avoid confusion. So how to write the next command? The next command is very simple. You simply need to follow your previous command, that is this one, and make some changes to it. What you need to do is, after TCP dump, start with minus W. Now minus W stands for write operation. So you simply need to write minus W and then the file name. For example, I can give it a file name as traffic capture dot pcap, then space and the entire filter that you wish. So this is the only change which we have made to the previous command. So now let's see how it looks once I press enter. As we have used minus V, it will display you something on the console. If minus V was absent, it would have simply written the output of that particular capture operation onto the pcap file, but without showing anything on the console. So this happens only because of the verbose that I have selected over here. Now let me quickly again fire a ping operation and check if anything is happening. As you can see, the number of packets are increasing. It has got 4-6 packets right now. So if I want to close it, I can simply enter Control C and move out of the console. Now this particular file should have been created. Let me go back to my desktop. And as you can see, this particular file has been created, traffic capture.pcap. Let me copy this and move into my shared folder so that I could view this file properly from my Windows machine as well. So let me go back to my Windows machine and go to the shared folder. As you can see, this is my shared folder and this is the file just now created, traffic capture.pcap. This is how it looks like. As you can see, 6 packets were captured, and this is how it looks like in Wireshark. Wireshark is basically a packet analyzer which is used to analyze all the packets from the PCAP file, right? So over here, as you can see, you can simply click on these particular packets and you will be able to see all the values or all the information related to those packets. This is what we are going to learn in the next video. I'm not going to cover Wireshark. I'm going to cover a different tool, that is EtherCAP, and using EtherCAP, how we can analyze the traffic captured packets with extension PCAP. So that's it in this particular video. I hope you understood how to capture packets using this tool, that is what we call as TCP dump. So in the next video, stay tuned. We are going to learn about how to analyze these packets one by one using a tool called EtherCAP. Thanks a lot.